progress. Okay.
To stand for our confession and forgiveness.
Oh, go ahead and start recording again.
I did.
Okay, great.
We gather in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let us confess our sin in the presence of God and of one another. Gracious God,
have mercy on us. We confess that we have turned from you and given ourselves into the power of sin. We are truly sorry and humbly repentant. In your compassion, forgive us our sins,
no,
things we have done and things we have failed to do. Turn us again to you and uphold us by your Spirit, so that we may live and serve you in the newness of life, through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen.
In the mercy of Almighty God, Jesus Christ was given to die for us, and for his sake, God forgives us all our sins. As a called and ordained minister of the Church of Christ, and by his authority, I therefore declare to you the entire forgiveness of all your sins, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Thank you.
our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
In peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace from above and for our salvation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace of the whole world, for the well-being of the Church of God, and for the unity of all, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this holy house and for all who offer here their worship and praise, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help, save, comfort, and defend us, gracious Lord.
Unite us with Christ and with each other in suffering and in joy, that all the world may be drawn into your bountiful presence. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Thank you.
us pray. Bless, O Lord, your servant Sarah Jane. As she reads to us the Holy Word, may our hearts burn within us as you open up to us the Scriptures through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
A reading from Acts. When the apostles had come together, they asked Jesus, Lord, is this the time when you will restore the kingdom to Israel? He replied, it is not for you to know the times or periods that the Father has set by his own authority, but you will receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you, and you will be my witness in Jerusalem, in all Judea and Samaria, and to the ends of the earth. When he had said this, as they were watching, he was lifted up, and a cloud took him out of their sight. While he was going, and they were gazing up toward heaven, suddenly two men in white robes stood by them. They said, Men of Galilee, why do you stand looking up toward heaven? This Jesus, who has been taken up from you into heaven, will come in the same way as you saw him go into heaven. When they returned to Jerusalem from the mount called Olivet, which is near Jerusalem, a Sabbath day's journey away, when they had entered the city, they went to the room upstairs where they were staying, Peter and John and James and Andrew, Philip and Thomas, Bartholomew and Matthew, James the son of Alphaeus, and Simon the Zealot, and Judas, son of James. All these were constantly devoting themselves to prayer, together with certain women, including Mary, the mother of Jesus, as well as the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The psalm will be read in regular print, Women Bold.
Let God arise, and let his enemies be scattered. Let those who hate him flee before him.
Let them vanish like smoke when the wind drives it away, as the wax melts at the fire, so let the wicked perish at the presence of God.
But let the righteous be glad and rejoice before God. Let the righteous be joyful.
Sing to God, sing praises to his name. Exalt him who rides upon the heavens. Yahweh is his name. Rejoice before him.
Father of orphans and tender widows, God is holy habitation.
God gives the solitary a home and brings forth prisoners into freedom, but the rebels shall live in dry places.
O God, when you went forth for your people, when you marched through the wilderness,
the earth shook and the skies poured down rain at the presence of God, the God of Sinai, at the presence of God, the God of Israel.
You sent a gracious rain, O God, upon your inheritance. You refreshed the land when it was weary.
Your people found their home in it. In your goodness, O God, you have made provision for the poor.
Sing to you, God, O kingdoms of earth. Sing praises to the Lord.
He rides in the heavens, the ancient heavens. He sends forth his voice, his mighty voice.
Ascribe power to God. His majesty is over Israel. His strength is in the skies.
How wonderful is God in his holy places. The God of Israel giving strength and power to his people. Blessed be God.
A reading from 1 Peter. Beloved, do not be surprised at the fiery ordeal that is taking place among you to test you, as though something strange were happening to you. But rejoice insofar as you are sharing God's suffering, so that you may also be glad and shout for joy when his glory is revealed. If you are reviled for the name of Christ, you are blessed, because the Spirit of glory, which is the Spirit of God, is resting on you. Humble yourselves, therefore, under the mighty hand of God, so that he may exalt you in due time. Cast all your anxieties on him, because he cares for you. Discipline yourselves. Keep alert, like a roaring lion adversary. The devil prowls around looking for someone to devour. Resist him steadfast in your faith, for you know that your brothers and sisters in all the world are undergoing the same kinds of suffering. And after you have suffered for a little while, the God of all grace, who has called you to his eternal glory in Christ, will himself restore, support, strengthen, and establish you. To him be the power forever and ever. Amen. The word of God, word of life.
Thanks be to God.
John, the 17th chapter. After Jesus had spoken these words to his disciples, he looked up to heaven and said, Father, the hour has come. Glorify your Son so that the Son may glorify you. Since you have given him authority over all people, go to give eternal life to all whom you have given him. And this is eternal life, that they may know you, the only true God, and Jesus Christ, whom you have sent. I glorified you on earth by finishing the work that you gave to me. So now, Father, glorify me in your own presence with the glory that I had in your presence before the world existed. I have made your name known to those whom you gave me from the world. They were yours, and you gave them to me. And they kept your word. Now they know that everything you have given me is from you. For the words that you give to me, I have given to them. And they have received them and know in truth that I came from you. And they have believed that you sent me. I am asking on their behalf. I am not asking on behalf of the world, but on behalf of those whom you have whom you gave me. Because they are yours. All mine are yours, and yours are mine, and I have been glorified in them. And now I am no longer in the world, but they are in the world, and I am coming to you. Holy Father, protect them in your name that you have given me, so that they may be one as we are one. The Gospel of our Lord. I invite the children forward for a message. Hey, turn one to sit beside me. Hey, so this is the last Sunday of Easter. I know. Pentecost is next Sunday. Pentecost is an exciting Sunday, too.
It is.
It is. But this is the last Sunday of Easter, and we celebrated something on Thursday, but we don't get together to celebrate it, but some churches do. Do you know what we might have celebrated before the end of Easter? Okay, so Jesus rises from the dead, right? Well, he walks along and is out among people, and then is he still like, are you going to run into Jesus sometime on the road or anything?
No. Is that when he goes back into heaven?
Yeah, we celebrated the Ascension on Thursday. Now, do you think that's good news that Jesus like goes back up into heaven?
Yeah.
Or is it kind of sad that he didn't stick around to walk around with people?
Sad, but also good.
Yeah, what do you think, Brett? Do you think that's good?
No, I think that's bad.
Yeah, you know, what about you, Katie? I haven't really thought about that. Well, you know, I think sometimes we feel like it's a loss, but if Jesus is here on earth, he's bound by his body, because it's bodily resurrection, so he walks around on earth, right? Now, even today, you know, certainly in Jesus' time, it was really hard to get around, you know, you'd have to walk or you'd have to take a donkey or a horse somewhere. But you wouldn't be able to, like, you know, you didn't have cars or boats or airplanes. But even today, doesn't it take a while to get from one part of the earth to the other?
Not if we're just moving like this.
Okay, but seriously, for a person, If you're trying to get from one part of the earth to the other, if you're trying to get from here to the other side of the earth, to China, wouldn't that take a long time?
Wait, China's on the other side of the earth?
Yeah.
I didn't know that.
Would that take a long time, do you think?
Not if you have an airplane.
It still takes a while though, right?
It takes like a few
weeks. Well, or overnight at least, right?
Yeah, but we went to Paris overnight.
We did go to Paris overnight. You're right. But you know what? If you needed Jesus like right away, you need to know that God was with you right away. You'd want to know Christ is with you right then, right? Mm-hmm. Well, because of the ascension, Jesus can be with all of us at every time and in every place when we need him. And he sends the Holy Spirit so that we know God is with us all the time. So it's a celebration for the ascension, to know that God is with us all the time, and not just with you and me, but with people all over the world. People over in Europe, people in Africa, people in South America, people in Paris.
People in China.
Yeah.
People in Brazil.
In Brazil, right.
No, people in Alaska.
People in Alaska. All those people can have God with them at the same time and know that Christ can be beside them because Jesus ascended. So that's why we celebrate Ascension Day. So today we're going to talk a little bit more about Ascension Day on the seventh Sunday of Easter. And next week we're going to celebrate Pentecost, the coming of the Holy Spirit. Thanks for coming up today. Grace and peace to you from our Lord and Savior, Jesus the Christ. So ascension does mean rising up. I was going to tell the kids that, but they kind of already figured that out since they knew what we were celebrating. But this week I'm reading the lessons, and did you ever get one of those songs stuck in your head that you heard a long time ago, and you can't quite place it, and you're not sure even who it was by or even what it was called? Do you ever have that experience where it just keeps going, or at least a little phrase of it keeps going and you can't quite figure it out? I had one of those experiences this week as I was reading a gospel lesson. And not actually probably the Acts lesson more than the gospel lesson, to be honest. But I knew it had something to do with God being with us. And I thought the lyrics had something to do with Jesus being with us and walking on the earth around among us, and that being this wonderful thing, you know, if Jesus were right beside us. But it turns out the refrain actually was God with us. That was one of my problems of figuring out which song it was. But the song I was thinking of is One of Us, and it was popular when I was in college. Apparently, Joan Orsman sang it. But it talked about if God was one of us. And the image was, you know, wouldn't it be great in some ways, or maybe God is one of us and we're not even realizing. And as I was Googling this, trying to figure out, you know, what song it was, I was kind of shocked by how many popular songs there are or were about Jesus. I noticed that a lot of them in the 80s and 90s, though. I'm not sure what happened in the 2000s. Maybe really spirituality has changed a lot. But, you know, apparently ZZ Top and Queen all both sang songs about God or Jesus being among us. Johnny Cash, the Rolling Stones had a song too. And they were fairly popular songs. I mean, when I looked at the lyrics, I thought, oh, I kind of remember that song. And I'm not real musical, and I remembered a lot of these songs that I was finding. So that theme of Jesus being right with us isn't just a church thing, it's something that speaks to popular culture as well. And I think one of the struggles with the ascension is that sense that we want to hold on to Jesus and we think it would be better. We think maybe our faith would be stronger if Jesus were right here among us. I mean, I guess growing up, I always thought, wouldn't we all believe in Jesus if he were out preaching and we could go and listen to him? And maybe we could meet him someday, maybe he'd be at some big stadium somewhere, and if we got to hear him preach, it would make all the difference not just to us, but to those people who are kind of on the fence and not sure about Jesus, that if they just experienced him in real life, or if they just saw Jesus healing somebody, and knowing that the healing was real and lasting, and it wasn't just something that was made up, something that was staged for good presentation, but if they saw it happen and genuinely saw Christ's love and Christ right in flesh, face to face, that people might embrace faith a little bit more. And so I struggled with, that's why I asked the kids that question, you know, is this a good thing that Jesus ascended or a bad thing? Because for a long time I really struggled with, is the ascension something to celebrate or something kind of to mourn? And yet, I believe what I told the kids, that Christ can be with all of us at one time. But there is something about knowing Jesus, about experiencing Jesus, about feeling like you've been face to face with God. And it's something that obviously sticks with us and resonates with us because it even sells popular music sometimes. You know, there are hit songs based on this concept. So I think it's helpful for us to think about what the ascension means, but also to think about this passage in John, because I think it gives us a sense of why the ascension is still a good thing. Jesus can't be with all of us all the time if he's still embodied. And yet, you come to church, or you come on Zoom, or you listen to this on YouTube week after week, because at some point, you have experienced the love of Christ. You have come to know Jesus. And if you don't, then you're searching for that relationship. But I'm convinced, because popular culture doesn't tell us to come to church anymore, you don't kind of get any society building you up saying, oh, everybody ought to belong to a church and be active in membership. It's not the 1950s anymore. That just doesn't happen. Nobody really cares whether you come to church or not. I mean, that's not true. All of us care because we are your brothers and sisters in Christ. We love to see you. We want to hear from you. We want to know what you need to be prayed for. We deeply care whether or not you're here. But the people that you work with on a day-to-day basis, they probably don't care whether you go to church or not. The people that are your neighbors, they probably don't care where you're going this morning when you left the house. It's probably not very relevant in their lives, but it's relevant to you because this is one of the times when you can be reminded that Christ is with you, that the Holy Spirit is among us, and it's not just something that happens later on after death that you can be with Christ, but that you can be in Christ's presence now. That's what the ascension means. Eternal life isn't completely possible without the death, the resurrection, and the ascension of Christ. And we don't put much emphasis on the ascension. So today I'm going to challenge you to think more about what it means that Christ ascends into heaven and is available 24 hours, 7 days a week, not just for you, but for people all around the world as well. And as you're pondering that, I also want you to look again at that gospel lesson. This is a prayer that Jesus is praying, and the disciples are overhearing it. And in the course of the prayer, there's a lot of things about the unity, and a lot of the basis of the unity of the Trinity. Jesus being one with God, and of course, we've already promised that the Holy Spirit is coming. So a lot of our understanding of God being Father, Son, and Holy Spirit is drawn upon from this prayer. And also the sense that we should be united with brothers and sisters in Christ, even those who aren't Lutheran. because there's something much more bonded, much more united than what divides us. But the other piece that's really important happens in this part of that prayer. We get eternal life defined. And I know, when we hear eternal life, usually our minds go to heaven. We think about what happens after death. We think about the glorious heavenly, maybe the grand city that you hear about in Revelation, maybe rolling green hills, maybe forest areas, maybe the river of life running through things, running through a city, or running through and making a beautiful natural habitat. For some of us, it's mountaintops. For some of us, it's beautiful valleys. For many of us, it involves our beloved pets that have gone before us, because we can't imagine heaven without them. But Jesus isn't defining eternal life as heaven at all. Not that that's not part of it. Not that that's not a promise that we're in God's presence in the future. But Jesus tells us clearly, eternal life is knowing God and knowing and being in relationship with Jesus. And that knowing is a deep knowing. It's not just the sense of, oh, there's a God out there, or knowing all of your scripture, being able to memorize text for a competition, or just to memorize because you feel like it's something helpful. But knowing and being known by God, being loved by God, being embraced by God, knowing in the deepest sense of knowing all about us, and us knowing about God, and being connected forever. That is eternal life. And that's able to happen because of the ascension itself. My prayer for you is that you experience eternal life today, that you know Christ, that you are known by God, the Creator, who fashioned you personally, who knows and loves and cares for you, by the Redeemer, by Jesus himself, who died for you and would do anything for you. And by the Holy Spirit, who is with you always, even when it seems that there's no one beside you, even if you seem to be all alone, the Holy Spirit is there. May you have the gift of eternal life, the life that Jesus prayed for us all. May you know that eternal life, and may you celebrate the ascension, trusting that it gives not just you eternal life, but the ability for eternal life for all who are created in the image of God.
Thank you.
words of the Nicene Creed. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen.
We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father, through whom all things were made, for us and for our salvation. He came down from heaven, by the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary, and was made man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate, he suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended to heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
United in the hope and joy of the resurrection, let us pray for the church, the world, and all in need. God of harmony, as you drew your Son to your side, you draw us to you and unite with a planet and another. Weave your church together in a web of mutual love for the sake of the world. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
As your Spirit hovered over the waters of creation, so your Spirit hovered over all that you have made. Bless the water that sustains the plant, and grant wisdom to use it wisely. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
You empower your people with the fire of your Spirit. Challenge activists, organizers, teachers, and politicians, and all leaders to speak the message of peace and justice. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
You care for all your children. Show your steadfast love to those suffering isolation, especially exiles, refugees, prisoners. Break the chain of all fast by sustaining oppression of any kind. Comfort all who are afraid of suffering for illness, especially
Lorraine, Doris Berger, Jerry Grant, Amy Brown, Nancy Brown, Sandy Brown, Kathy Cable, Chuck and Family, Ben Curl, Bob Curl, Diane, Ann Schaefer Davis, Susan Dittmer, Craig Donahue, James Dobbs, Nicole Dudek, Carol Fensel, Ed Fensel, Diane Foltz, Steve Gardner, Ken Getz, Linda Griffith, Rosie Marino, Mike Katz, Greg Hoover, Doug Hopkins, Rick Hopkins, Dorea Hummer, Chris Jones, Karen Papp, Barb Lehman, Pearl Lamer, Bartok Lepchuk, Jim Loy, Keith Loy, Marburger Family, Marta, Nina McElwain, Charlotte Miller, Steve Nelson, Alice Parks, Sandy Quinlan, William Reynolds, Harold Ruthman, Dolores Ruth, Darlene Sanders, Fred Sanders, Ed Sessman, Nicole Shields, Phoebe Shawley, John Schumberger, Brian Smee, Brian Smee, Al Skirmiglio, Peggy Skirmiglio, Stephanie Sackfield, Amanda Stoltz, Carol Stoltz, Lisa Tabarina, Donald Thomas, Shirley Vogelsong, Cheryl Ward, Michael Ward, Courtney Welk, Brian Williams, Mary Genchko, Mary Ziegler.
And those we name before you now, aloud or in our hearts.
For the Jones family.
The Jones family.
Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
We give thanks that humankind serves as your body in the world, stewarding your abundant gifts. Guide this congregation's leaders as they seek your will. We pray for our staff and council. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
We raise your saints to new life in Christ. We give you thanks for Helena and all your saints who have given us glimpses of your redeeming love. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Rejoicing in the victory of Christ's resurrection, we lift our prayers and praise to you, Almighty and Eternal God, through Jesus Christ, our risen Lord.
Amen.
Give us the light we need, awaken us to the needs of others, and at the end, bring all the world to your feast, through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be honor and glory forever.
Amen.
As Christ has taught us, we are bold to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
The God of all who raised Jesus from the dead, bless you by the power of the Holy Spirit to live in the new creation.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you. Thanks be to God.